do not have that luxury been able to source additional funding. And there's a real danger as we integrate further, rightly integrate further, with our social care, with rural community NHS, that we get ourselves into an open-ended commitment, requiring us to put more funds in to meet our share of the cost. So weakness number two, you can't have an SDP unless you've got full local authority involved. Finally, just let me say this, I think we do need a plan. There's no doubt about it, we do need a plan. There's nothing wrong with that idea, but we need a proper plan, we need to have it properly assessed and costed, and so far, we just have not got it.
Can we wind up, please?
Separate. honest answer is that grammar schools are not a magic bullet. However, a one-size-fits-all policy doesn't work for most things, so why should we expect education to be any different? The argument for the need to grammar schools means a return to poor secondary modern education. For the rest, is a red herring. It is also highly offensive to the National Association of Secondary Moderns, with whom I recently discussed this issue. Why should the alternative option be a poor offer? It doesn't have to be. Different children need different types of support. This does not mean putting a ceiling on the aspirations of those who don't attend grammar school. It just means a different method of getting there. It also doesn't mean withdrawing the option of comprehensive education for those who want it, thereby retaining choice. Another argument is that grammar schools benefit the middle classes and the rich, leaving the poor behind who can't afford the tutoring needed to pass the entry exam. Firstly, how is this any different to the cost of housing, pricing the disadvantage out of the catchment area of good and outstanding schools? Secondly, it once again shows that grammar schools had to be the same as before. We could look at any model for entry that will help those disadvantaged children to get onto that ladder. We could look at pupil premium money in place for bright children, or entry criteria taking account of preschool meal status, for example. A similar system was used in the US to relax entry requirements for university for African American students, who then went on to achieve equal results as their counterparts. It is about providing the initial push. Finally, Mr. Mayor, we talk about narrowing the gap. What if instead we halted the gap from happening in the first place by improving early years education? Then perhaps children from disadvantaged backgrounds will surely have equal opportunity to get into grammar school. Mr. Mayor, only then will we have provided the ladder fully intact and help those onto the most suitable path who may falter without our help. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Sit there and be sent to a secondary modern school. Thank God, at the age of 13, that comprehensive education was brought in. I was the first member of my family and extended family to be able to take GCSEs, A-levels and go on and receive a university education. Because of that, my children have all received university education from Woodchurch High School, the comprehensive service. And I will fight any motion, any hint of destroying the education system that the Labour Party created, which was equality, and to actually harp on about how grammar schools and elitist education systems benefits the poor is absolute nonsense. Yeah. Absolute nonsense. The short start education and the support for disadvantaged young children was brought in by Labour government. Nothing to do with the Tories. Yeah. Nothing to do with the Tories. And I will fight my last breath to oppose any sort of selective elitist education system that the Tories bring to the table.
Concern about standards and action to improve them should be focused on all children and young people, not a minority. Moreover, issues of workload, shortages of staff and low morale within schools are in danger of being ignored because this government has chosen instead to have a debate about selection.
Yes.
Local authorities and this Wirral in particular work to support the overall well-being of all children and young people. But the work has a particular focus on children and young people with special educational needs and disabilities, SEND. The fact that children and young people with SEND were not mentioned once in the consultation document, which is called Schools That Work For Everyone, is a disgrace, really. Absolute disgrace. It's not mentioned once in the document. And I think it's a failure of some of the most important barriers, and the reason for why I say it is a failure is because children with special education needs have always been a part of this council, the most vulnerable children, as we saw recently in the Oxford discussion. We here in this party believe that mainstreaming, assisted by specific child-centred support, is appropriate and should be the guiding principle for any future government interventions in the structure of schools. There is clear evidence of the deleterious effect of the selective principle on the educational, psychological and social well-being of many children and young people. Recent people to support the our stances, Sir Michael Wiltshaw said it's an absolute, it is disgraceful that we should be talking about the expansion of grammar schools. He wanted people to talk about the London Challenge set up by Labour 10 years ago, where the outcomes for children and young people have been fantastic from early years right up to GCSE and A level. We have the best outcome. That's what we should be modelling local authorities on. And we in this authority here in Wirral do that. We have interventions that are very, very similar to the London Challenge. So it's not an expansion of grammar schools. That's for the elite. 2%, just 2.5% of children who go to grammar schools are on preschool meals.
Thank you. Okay, I'm having Councillor Lewis, Councillor Kelly, Councillor Walter Smith, Councillor Green, and Councillor Spriggs, and then I'm going to call for a second there. Councillor Lewis.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, and again, for the second time tonight, can I thank my council colleague, Councillor Sykes, for outlining the arguments in favour of this. Mr. Mayor, like Councillor Fowkes, I don't enforce any kind of system on any parents or any child in this borough, but I of those schools in those late in the 70s, under only a Labour council, but that doesn't matter, it's the system, not the party. The results in those schools across Knowsley were absolutely diabolical. So in the 1970s, Mr Mayor, my parents, who lived in a damp rented house in Highton, sold everything they had, and this is a bit of a tear, there you go, sold everything they had to move to Wirral, where they had grammar schools and better results for the kids who went there. And they moved to a house in Knowles, because in those days you could still afford to buy a house in Knowles. And I went for a year to Great Knowles Primary. Now, earlier today, Mr Mayor, I attended the funeral for my primary school teacher, the only primary school teacher I had at Great Knowles, Miss Dorothy Iris Clayton, who died earlier this month, aged 90. Her advice to me, Mr Mayor, because I was the new kid in the school, all the other kids had had years of coaching, years of extra lessons, because the parents could afford that, because the parents wanted their kids to go to grammar schools, and they would pay the extra because they could afford to. My parents couldn't afford to pay the extra. I had to sit the 11 plus as the poor kid, if you like, on the block. Mr Mayor, I sat the 11 plus, and I failed the 11 plus, and I'm not ashamed of that at all, because as Miss Clayton said to me when I failed the 11 plus, she said, I would rather you were the top of Pilbury than the bottom of Colby. And that advice, Mr Mayor, is that whatever school you go to has to be appropriate for your needs and your abilities, and I don't regret failing the 11 plus at all. I'm very proud of the education I had in the grammar school system. My concern is that too many parents in Wirral and across the country do not have access to the kind of choice that my parents decided to offer to buy for me. Now, my concern, Mr Mayor, as our most emotion calls for, is the wider choice. Whether that choice is at 11, I personally think 11 is too young. 14, now that we have schooling to 18, 14 might be a better age. But the overriding principle, Mr Mayor, has to be parental choice. Because otherwise, if we keep doing what the likes of Knowsley did in the 1970s, we'll keep getting results like none of Knowsley were getting in the 1970s.
As I stand here, the most impressive one, I'm not going to name names,
with selective education is education becoming an obstacle course. I mean, the great thing about the system we have, that you go to your local secondary school, you get, and it's like no bad belt. As long as you're going to take advantage of it, you're going to do well, you'll move on and upwards. And many of us here will be part of schools, will be many of us that are governors. And we all know how the heads, the staff, are striving for better, higher standards. But there are some difficulties, you know, we unfortunately still haven't dealt with some of the social problems in this country. But for the majority of people, and certainly in Wirral, the educational opportunity is tremendous. Yeah, I can speak, you know, from my family's point of view, all my children, all my grandchildren, we're all working class. My father was a pastor, my mother was a waitress, so we're working class. But I didn't manage that. Now, I was brought up in Wallasey, a bit like my comrades here, that in Wallasey, when I was 11, you have more chances of going to a grammar school than any other place in the whole of the country. Wallasey has a tremendous range of grammar schools. I failed to get in one. But again, where I would agree with your Tory motion is, of course, the early years of education, foundation years at primary level, are extremely important. For myself, of course, I was brought up during the war. I missed from 5 to 10. And consequently, the 11 plus wasn't certainly on my radar. But I'm very grateful to the Army Education Corps, because that was my university, and it is possible. But certainly, selective education is not the way. I mean, what you'd be saying is back to the past with the Tories, and what we need is a well-funded education system that benefits everyone, and a level playing field, and you won't get it with selective education.
Thank you, Mr. May. It strikes me as though the Labour Party haven't read our resolution. It talks about, you know, it's not a fix-all. It talks about what the benefits of being in Wirral and the range of selective schools and comprehensive and so on and so forth. So it talks all about that. But what it does say, is that we should put our ideology away and ensure that parents who will have an insight into what's going to work best for their young kids, because as Stuart said, he's going out to schools and determining what's going to be in the best interest, is that parents have that opportunity. And I want to say, I believe absolutely passionately that education is a real ladder out of poverty, out of deprivation. And therefore, we should be encouraging and supporting those parents and those children who want to use the education system, want to use an academic education system out of those circumstances. There's nothing wrong. And really, truthfully, it has been highlighted this debate that actually the disagreement about selective education is ideological. The Labour Party still want to tell everybody what to do. What they don't want to do is to allow. It's to allow. Mr. Mayor,
please.
Thank you for your protection, Mr. Mayor. The fact remains, the Labour Party still, I've heard it tonight, believe, not everywhere, but in certain places, still believe that what they believe goes and what that parents and children should acquiesce to their view about how a society should be organised. What I believe, and what I believe this resolution is suggesting, people where it wants them. That's why they are so afraid of giving people an opportunity. That's why they will fight this tooth and nail. And that's why this party will always be in favour of opportunities for all.
Thank you.
central budget, the crisis in social care here in Wirral means that I believe that we will have to adopt the fast track approach. So this means